Hello friends, in my previous video I have shown you how to bind to a service on button click and how to unbind a service on button click. Now in this video I will show you how to interact with a bounded service or how to communicate with a bounded service. So in this main activity I have a button, and when I click on this button it will execute a task in service class. So here I have this button called show time. When I click on show time, it will execute a method in service class and it will show the time in this text view 1. So here I have this text view 1 which shows the current time. Initially it will show the current time, and whenever I click on this button it will show the time when the button was clicked. Then I have this text view 2 which shows whether the service is bound or not. So then I have button 1 which binds to service, button 2 unbinds from service, and button 3 shows time. It executes a task in the service class. In main activity.java, here I have declared text view 1 and text view 2 as static classes, and I have defined them in onCreate. Then I have declared and defined button 1, button 2 and button 3 using their IDs in onCreate. Then for text view 1, I have set the text to the current time, which is new date. And then I have onClick listener for button 1, button 2 and button 3. And all these three are empty. So to bind to a service, we need a service connection and we need a service. So first I will create a service class, new Java class, and let's name it as test service. So this class is test service. Okay, I don't know why this happened. So now we have this class test service, and this will be a service class. So here I will write extends service, and since it extends the service it must contain the onBind method. Just type onBind and it will show public iBinder onBind. When you click enter it will automatically add this onBind method, which returns null at present, but ideally it should return an iBinder. And from iBinder we can get this class which is test service. So now we go to main activity and define a service connection so that we can bind to this service class. So here I will define a service connection called connection is equal to new service connection. So now it has added this new service connection. And it contains these two methods, on service connected and on service disconnected. On service connected, it gets this iBinder called service. So from this iBinder, we have to get this test service. So I'll show you how to do that. But first, let's bind to the service. Here I will add a Boolean variable which will tell me whether we are bound or not. So here I have a Boolean called bound. Okay, so initially it will be false. When service is connected I will set bound is equal to true, and on service disconnected I will set bound equal to false. Now to connect to service, on button 1 click I will use intent equal to new intent. First we have to get the context or the activity, which is main activity dot this comma. We have to enter the class to which we have to move, so that will be test service dot class. and then we can bind to this service, writing bind service intent. Then we have to use the connection, comma, it should be bind auto create. So this will bind to the service and execute onBind method here. Now how to unbind to service? So when button 2 is clicked, we have to unbind this service. For that, we have to check if it is bound. So first I will check if bound. If bound, then we have to unbind. Unbind service connection. And we have to set bound equal to false. Okay, so whenever this bound is true, we can set the text of text view to text view 2 dot set text service bound, and when it is bound equal to false, we can set the text to service not bound. Okay, similarly here when button 2 is clicked, we can set the text of text view 2 to service not bound. Okay, so now we can bind to service and unbind from service, but our service is empty. So here we need a method to update the text of text view 1. So here I will add a method, public void. I will add a void method, update, let's name it as update time. So this is a void method, and in this I will set the text of text view 1. I will set the text of text view 1 to current time. So here I will just paste this text view 1, and I will write main activity dot text view 1. So it can get the text view 1 now. So how to use this update time in main activity? We cannot use the update time in main activity directly. Suppose here if I write test service dot update time, you can see that it doesn't show update time here. So for that we have to get the service here. For getting the service, we can get it in on service connected method. Here you can see that here we get the iBinder. So we have to get it from the iBinder. So the iBinder must return on in onBind method, it must return an iBinder. So for that we will define a class for this iBinder. So let's define a class, public class my binder extends binder. Android.os.binder. So now this is a class, and in this class we have to get the service, test service. So here I will define a method, test service get service. And this should return that test service. So here I will return test service dot this. And I will use this to define a new binder. So here I will define my binder, binder 1 is equal to new my binder. So up to this it is fine, and in onBind method we can return this binder 1. So now we will get this binder 1 in main activity here. This service will be the binder 1. So here we will define the my binder which is test service dot my binder, and we will name it as binder is equal to service. Okay, but we have to specify the type. So here I will specify that it is my binder, test service dot my binder. From this service we can get the from this my binder we can get the service using the code service.getService. For that we have to declare service here. So here I will declare test service. Let's name it as service 1. So here I will define this service 1. Service 1 is equal to binder dot get service. Here you can see that this binder, which is my binder, contains the get service method, and this returns the test service. So we will get the test service, and now service 1 is equal to this test service. So we can use service 1 in main activity now. So here we can add service 1 dot update time when button 3 is clicked. You can see that test service contains update time, and now we have used it in button 3 on click. Now we have to go to android manifest.xml and declare our service here. Service name test service. Okay, and that's all. Now let's run the project. So now it has launched, and you can see it displays the current time. When I click on bind service, it shows service bound. When I click on unbind service, it says service not bound. Okay, and there's one error which I have, mistake which I have done. When button 3 is clicked, I must check if it is bound or not. So here I will check if bound, only then I can update the time. Yeah, so now let's run it once again. Okay, so now it shows the current time. When I click on bind, it shows service bound. And when I click on show time, you can see that the time changes here. Okay, and when I click on unbind service, it shows service not bound. And when I again click on show time, it doesn't show the time because it is not bound. So when I click on bind service, now it is bound to the service, and now I can update the time by clicking on show time. So it will update the time here. So whenever I click it, it will update the time. That's all in this video. Thank you very much for watching this.